fucking quarantine. But it's time for the live stream. Today we celebrate St. George's Day, the feast day of St. George, who is the patron saint of England! Woohoo!
Well, good show! Quality!
The patron saint of England is some guy who could be a Roman soldier, or he could be some dude in Turkey, who is famous for killing a dragon.
I love it. Because you're exercising.
St. George's feast day is celebrated on the 23rd of April in most major Christian churches around the world, and it's the day in which we believe that St. George actually died during the Diocletian persecution. If you have any clue what that means, if you don't, look it up on the internet, and I'm sure you'll read all sorts of things about it. But basically, you have the patron saint of England slaying a dragon, a mighty dragon. It's a fantastic story, and it's a wonderful source of unity for certainly the people of England and for the church as well, to think about bravery and facing battles against mighty things like coronavirus 19 and other things. I'm wearing my hospital scrubs. I'm about to head out to another shift over at the hospital where we can do battle with this mighty dragon. Well, you know it's getting real when on St. George's Day, the Queen herself cancels the Trooping of the Colour. So...
And now, coming into your picture, is what we've all been waiting for, leading the procession, Her Majesty the Queen.
So, if the Queen can cancel the Trooping of the Colour on St. George's Day, then we can actually stay at home and not put ourselves into close proximity to other people in an effort to mitigate the damage that can be caused by this nasty disease. So you don't have to be in the city streets waving flags to celebrate St. George's Day. You can do it right where you are. And you can think of new ways to be courageous and faithful in everything that you do. So it's time for story time. Once upon a time, I got to go to Buckingham Palace.
Do you know what that great big building is called over there?
This is Buckingham Palace. Did you don't know this?
And I thought best story time for St. George's Day would be me in Buckingham Palace. I was going around on a tour inside when all of a sudden we heard the sound of drums and marching. And so a couple of my friends and I went to the main atrium, which actually is kind of the where you can look out to the front of the palace, and the folks that were gathered there were from a choir that I was traveling with from Jacksonville, Florida. And we looked out the front door, and sure enough, they were trooping the color. They were doing what's called the changing of the guard in front of the palace. And so we stood there, and we thought, how amazing. We're actually watching the changing of the guard from the Queen's perspective. And it was really cool to be able to stand in the palace, looking through the archway and watching the soldiers march, listening to the band as they went back and forth in front of the palace. And we could see all the tourists gathered at the fence just behind the band. And it was a wonderful, wonderful day. We traveled around inside Buckingham Palace looking at different things, and we ended up out in the back garden behind the palace at the end of the day. It was gorgeous. It was lovely, and sometimes it's really, really nice to kind of think about heritage, and tradition, and history, and sometimes you kind of get dipped in it, and when you come out of it, it covers you like wax on a candle. It's a new layer, a new perspective, and so for me, I live in the United States of America in the Appalachian Mountains, but with this perspective of what it's like to be dipped into the life of the royal family, to be dipped into the history of England, and to be dipped into the history of the people of St. George and the dragon. Got a new job. Someone said, hey, what's it like working with a hot air balloon company? And I looked at him and I said, it's got its ups and its downs.
Help.
Whoa!
Why did the crab never share? Because he's shellfish.
He's So is that it, or is there something important you need to discuss?
So wherever you are today, stay happy, stay positive. Try your best to do something interesting, invigorate your mind. Watch a documentary on television about a subject that you know nothing about. But try and remain positive, hopeful, and folks, it might be gray and dreary outside today. It's been raining all morning. I could sit here and be moany about the fact that the ground's wet. But I know that the sun is going to shine. It's going to be dry, as I've said before on the Love Stream. The sun will shine, and things are going to get better. Stay positive. Spread the love. And this is for my sons.